All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from the coast out here in Rockaway Beach. A little windy outside to get the video in, but we moved inside. We got this thing covered. Every week, I do a national video. I do a Pac-12 video. I do a duck video. This one is about the Pac-12. I love doing the Pac-12 video. It's one of my favorite videos to do each week. And it really, again, just shows how good this conference is week after week, where for us, from our perspective, again, the national media doesn't see it. I get it. But there's some good football out here. And every week, you can't take it for granted. A lot of good football to be played out here. So let's go ahead and let's get this in. This is one of my favorite videos of the week. Started off on the Friday night. Wow. What a game on a Friday night. Looked like Arizona could do it. And again, like this is what I'm kind of saying is that week to week, you never know what you're going to get out here in the Pac-12. That was one of them. That was an insane game for Washington to be able to come away with that victory. And I think if you're an Oregon fan, you want to see your future opponents come away with victories. Okay. So I think that you're rooting, not necessarily rooting for the Huskies, but I think that you want the Huskies to continue to do well. And this was a game that you do not want them to lose. Arizona, they're putting it together. They're trying their best. But and this was actually a fairly good game for them. But it was, again, Friday night on the road for Huskies. Tough assignment. The Washington State BYU game was another barn burner. This is a game that I think if Rolovich was there, they win. If they don't have all the stuff and turmoil they had to deal with in the last week, they were on a roll. They were just the mentality of that team was running. And I do feel like they kind of had the legs taken out from underneath them a little bit with this Rolovich situation. And this is a loss that, you know, they definitely wanted to have that win. And now freaking BYU is 4-0 against the Pac-12. That's not a good look. But they're back in the top 25, and they're again, that's a situation where, you know, the Pac-12 is so close to knocking some of these teams off and doing what they need to do, and that's the worst of those Pac-12 schools, pretty much, that they're going to be playing, or one of, and Washington State, after a three-game winning streak, you know, can't get it done against BYU. That's rough. Cal Colorado, I watched a lot of this game because, again, the idea that next week's opponent for the Ducks, Colorado. This was a game that interests the heck out of me, and I was surprised by this one. Again, coming off of last week's success with Colorado against Arizona, I thought Colorado had kind of figured it out. They were on a turn, and they were moving in the right direction. This sends them back a little bit, which is kind of frustrating. And Cal. Cal's in a unique situation because, again, they're not giving up on their season. They still have a lot to play for in their mind. And they're trying to get their season right, and they're not about to try to lose a game like this. And the way that it played out was just amazing to me, that Cal's defense looked so much better than it did even the week before. Obviously, I think Cal is playing better, and I think that Oregon game shows it, that it was a tough game. But I think Cal will continue to improve this year, and they're going to knock somebody off here, maybe a team that they shouldn't beat on paper. They're gonna beat. USC Notre Dame, always a great game. Always just the pageantry alone. You know, they tried to make it interesting, but Notre Dame is a pretty good team this year. You know, Notre Dame, outside that loss to Cincy, I really thought they had something going on this year, and I thought they were going to put themselves in a very unique position outside looking in, or maybe even knocking on the door to that four-team playoff. If they were undefeated, definitely, but if they had one loss, still in the conversation. And they find themselves kind of just creeping right on that situation, right on that front door there. And this was a big win for them. Even though USC's down, this is not the same USC team we're used to, but blah, 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 blah. This is still a good victory for them. And SC still has quality players on the team. They're just not playing that well. The Oregon-UCLA game was, I think, the game of the day, just on the idea of just being a fan of football and watching the game. Seeing a team go down early, Oregon do nothing wrong, a block punt, dig yourself a 14-point hole, then come back, score 34 points, 34-3, basically. In that run, and you know, just again, put yourself in a situation where you can really go ahead and do some stuff going forward. If you're the Ducks, if the Ducks lose that game, they're in a real, real tough situation there. And UCLA, again, just so close, right? Digging themselves or putting himself on a 14-point pedestal in the first quarter and then digging himself a hole and getting down. I mean, that's a crazy situation for them. But we've seen that act before with Chip Kelly. Again, I think a lot of people are admired with the Chip Kelly days of just the wins, but they don't remember the losses. There was a lot of them like that where they got ahead early and they got caught at the end. But this team offensively does not look the same as the Chip Kelly teams. I've been saying that the whole week. I do think that they have some really quality pieces around DTR, but they just not the same type of team, and he's gonna continue to kind of just plateau. I think I don't think that that team's gonna excel any time in the future. I think these are some of the better players you're gonna have. If you continue to recruit well, maybe they rise up and they really start to kind of put themselves on a different pedestal. But at this point, I feel like they're the third best team in the South pretty much every year. And then the Beeve game. Whoa. Man, you got to give it up to the Beavos. Man, hard-fought game, down to the wire. This was a hell of a game. And this is, again, you know, as for a Duck fan, who do you root for, right? You know the Utah game is going to be at the end of the year, and you know that the Beavos are going to be bringing it for the, whatever you want to call it, rivalry game, Civil War. It's going to be awesome, and I do think that this is shaping up to be one of those just very special years where whoever wins that Civil War is going to get a chance to be a really, really good team, one, because I do think the two best teams in the North right now are Oregon State, and I also think that whoever's going to get out of there are going to get a pretty good bowl, and the momentum of winning that game should propel them into a pretty good bowl season. Even the loser of that game is probably at this point still going to be able to go to a bowl. I think Oregon State's going to see some success going forward on their schedule as well. I just thought this Utah game could have been one of those games where, you know, Utah scores late and maybe they pull out a victory. But, you know, to win at home for the home fans of the Beavos, you know, they deserve that. And they've had a really, really kind of a rough run of it lately. And to have Jonathan Smith, you know, alumni who knows how to win, who's been winner there, who's seen success, put them in the right place is awesome to see. So I'm stoked to see for the Beavs on that one. And I do think that the Beavs and Utah both look beatable for Oregon. I'll put that out right now. I think that Oregon looking forward, if they can play like they did against UCLA going forward, I think Oregon's going to be the team to beat in the conference. Let's talk about next week. All right. Cougars, man. Oh, wow. Going down to the desert. You know what? I would not want to play ASU. I think ASU is gonna turn things around here a little bit. And, you know, Washington State, this is just a tough timing of playing the Sun Devils. I think coming off of a weird game, a non-conference game in the middle of the conference schedule, and coming off of a game like that where you probably felt like you should have won against BYU, turn around and play ASU. I don't know how the Cougs are going to do this. Well, I do think ASU wins by a touchdown or two, especially down there. It could get wild. Colorado, Oregon, you know, I at the beginning of the year, I thought this game was actually going to be a pretty good game. I thought Colorado was going to continue to get better from last year, continue to kind of be on the rise a little bit, good coaching staff, getting pretty good players in there, and then the program is building. You could tell it was building, right? But then just had some really weird games this year, you know, games where feels like they should have won, where they didn't win, and then games maybe where they you know, the other way around. But, you know, the A&M game I keep going back to, you know, they were so close to A&M, and A&M goes off to beat Alabama, so you can tell this is a good quality team. But, you know, it's just how they're playing at any given Saturday is a different situation. So, coming to Autzen, I think this is going to be a great game. The day before Halloween, I think people are going to be fired up for this game. It should be a really great game. It's a 12:30 start. So, again, just right in the middle of the day, smack dab. It's going to be a beautiful, beautiful opportunity for the Ducks and the Duck fans to get in, get a home day game, because we love a day game. Not to say the night games aren't fun, but we've had a couple already this year, so it's nice to get a day game in there. Arizona, SC, wow. Arizona's going to get plastered, it feels like. SC needs a win badly, and this is a win that USC has probably circled on their calendar that's a gimme. Now, Arizona's playing better, and I wouldn't put it past Arizona to give USC some trouble here, but USC is a real question mark going forward, and this should be a game USC handles easily. The Oregon State-Cal game, though, is going to be interesting because, again, the way that Cal played last week was so radically different than how they played earlier in the year. I think Cal has a real shot here. Do some damage. They're playing at home. Cal, you know, historically doesn't have the greatest home advantage, but, you know, the Bevo still got to go on the road, pack it up, and see if they can rebuild the dam in Berkeley. And I do think the Bevos have a chance to win and win pretty significantly if they play the way they need to play, which is just running the ball, having two different running backs. They're both very dynamic, throwing the ball out of that and having that big bruising quarterback they can bring in, Coletto, to jam the ball there at the goal line. You know, I think the Bevos have some real, real tough assignments here. So if you're Cal. So I think Cal's got their hands full. But I do think Cal can make it interesting, especially like I said, the way they played last week. UCLA-Utah is going to be a great game. You know, I think both teams reeling a little bit after a loss. Both teams quality teams. This is, again, who's the better team? Who's the third place team in the Pac-12 South? Who's the second place team in the Pac-12 South? This is probably the game that's going to decide that. So, again, this is a big game for them up at Utah. You know, I don't know how well UCLA is going to travel. This is a game historically UCLA would probably win in some weird fashion. I thought they were going to win this Oregon game in some weird fashion as well. So, again, anything can happen out here in the Pac-12. That's why we like to watch these games. But I do like Utah to win. I do like Utah to continue to put pressure on the Pac-12 South and put pressure on Oregon, especially in that game late at Salt Lake. The game of the night, though, Washington-Stanford. I love the Washington-Stanford matchup. You know, if Washington continues to lose, you know, they're in to find themselves in some real trouble. You know, last week had a big win, Friday night win. They needed that win really, really bad, right? But Stanford is playing just well enough. Huskies got to go on the road, go down to Stanford, night game. It's not like it's going to be a great environment fan-wise, but still got to go on the road. It's going to be a tough matchup for the Huskies, I think. You know, this is just a team that just, if you match up well with Stanford, then you're going to play well. Oregon had a tough time with some late calls or whatever else. They call what you want, but Stanford hung with Oregon every single play, that for the most part, that whole game. So you get right down to it, and this is a situation where I think Washington's going to have their hands full. I do think Washington can win, and I would actually like to see Washington win. I'd like to see Stanford get one more loss, but I'd also like to see Washington continue to get better, especially before the Oregon-Washington matchup, which, again, I think is going to be the awesome one the week after up there in Seattle. So, again, super pumped up. Thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Appreciate